Now I had a concept to make a venison burger. I was gonna take Pennsylvania leeks with some smoked bacon. Now my sister-in-law Georgia called me up and she said Uncle Tommy had the best rabbit recipe there was. It's appropriate because my wife's Uncle Tommy was a Korean vet and I named the sandwich after him. I thought if I could throw Uncle Tommy's rabbit on top and make this Memorial Day burger more memorable, I'm gonna do it. Now we're gonna use Uncle Tommy's rabbit recipe. Now it takes like an hour and a half, not quite prep the plate in 30 minutes, but it's gonna be worth it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get that rabbit on, start cooking, and come back, and then we're gonna set those burgers up. Then I looked at the recipe, and all it is six onions cut up roughly, put in a pan, a little bit of olive oil, salt and pepper the rabbit, and cook for an hour and a half. It is that simple. The onions themselves will make the sauce for the rabbit to cook in. All right, now I'm gonna quarter up this rabbit. Now it's the same way I did in the other show. I'm gonna salt and pepper each piece. And a tablespoon of allspice. That is all that's in it. Onion, allspice, salt and pepper, and rabbit. Make sure you get them nice and covered. Put them on the stove for an hour, hour and a half, and they're done. I'm gonna check this rabbit out. I see it could use a little more juices, so I'm gonna add a cup of water. That way the rabbit won't dry out and have some nice juices on it. Take your favorite barbecue sauce, about a cup of it, put 2 tablespoons or more of honey, and mix that up, and that's your sauce for the venison burger. This recipe calls for like 1 pound of venison. And I have 3 leeks, Pennsylvania leeks here. I'm gonna dice them up real tiny. Now you can use scallions as an optional. But I'm also gonna use the greens. The greens will add moisture and nice flavor to these burgers. I'm gonna take my smoked bacon. This is gonna add smoky flavor and keep the venison from drying out. I'm gonna use 1 egg, salt and pepper. Add that venison. Now here's a tip I just found out. Add 2 tablespoons of olive oil to your burgers and they'll never dry out. Should be able to get 3 nice patties out of 1 pound of venison. I'm just gonna get them on the grill. It's been a little over an hour, and that rabbit is ready to come off. Oh, wow, you can really smell the onions and everything coming out of that. This rabbit is actually falling apart inside the pan. So what I'm gonna do is you take a fork and you just work it off. Now as you see, this rabbit is just flaking apart. Uncle Tommy knew what he was doing when he did this recipe. That is tender. You take some barbecue sauce, put on top of that venison. Take some Uncle Tommy's pulled rabbit. And just drizzle a little bit more barbecue sauce. Wow, that's starting to build to be beautiful. Now, we were very fortunate that my brother-in-law John put together a family cookbook. Hey, I got Uncle Tommy's rabbit recipe out of it. So if you have family members out there who have special recipes, get out there, talk to them, write it down.